Hello everyone, Johnny here. Today we will try to solve how to print distinct array elements. Distinct in the sense it will try to remove the duplicate elements and it will try to print all the array elements. It will try to remove the duplicate array elements. So before trying to solve this, let us try to write the basic methods in order to solve this question. First one, let me take an array here. I have taken array 1, 2, 3, 4. In this array, for example, I want to push some element. If I want to push something like 40, I'm trying to write console.log A. If you can see here, push will try to add the element at the end of an array. We have taken an array literal here. Array name is A and it has array index for 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And we are trying to add an element at the end of an array. So let us check the output. If we can see here, so let me save this. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 40. So array push will try to insert the element at the end of an array. And push will try to return the length of new array. So we can see the length here. Next one, index of. For example, I'm trying to write a dot index of 2. Console dot log of. So let me take this in the I variable I. Or else we can write console dot log of a dot index. So if we can see here, we got 1. So if I'm trying to take the same statement, and I'm trying to pass the values like 40, you can see here the answer is 4. That is the index value. If I want to take like something like 750, if the element is not there, index of will try to return -1. You can see for the line number 20 it is -1. So here we have trying to learn about push method followed by index of. Now let us try to take an array. And we will try to implement some logic for it. So in this I am trying to take variable students equals to Johnny. Arif, Meena, Sridhar, Vasu, and let me take some element here again. I'm trying to take Johnny again here. So somewhere in the between, let me try to take the pass the same value here. If you can see, we have some array elements. If I want to print this, we can write console.log of students. So it will try to return the array values. Now the logic is we should able to remove the duplicate values. That is, it should able to print the distinct array elements. So first, let me pass these values in a function. So I'm trying to take where unique equals to. Let me take a function name as getUnique of students. So I'm trying to pass the student values here. So function name is console. So let me write the same value here. Look, can we write this thing? Yes. So I'm trying to write getUnique function name. Function getUnique. In this, we are trying to pass the parameter array. If we can see here, the function name is getUnique The arguments is students, the list of array values, and we are trying to pass here array is a parameter, functions space the function name. Now in order to make sure that array will contain these values, so what I am trying to take is that let me try to take an empty array where it will try to push out all these elements. So before trying to take this array elements, let us try to take a loop where it will try to iterate the list of the values. So here the array is arr.length. So simply we are trying to iterate the array elements. So this for loop will try to iterate all the array elements. But when it is trying to iterate, it should try to check some condition whether it is already present in the array or not. So for this, what I'm trying to take is that I will try to take an empty array now. Variable unique equals to some empty array name. In this, I'm trying to pass some condition in this for loop. Inside this for loop, we will try to write unique, that is array name, empty array name, index of. What is the index of here? It will try to first check with array value equals to -1 in the if condition. So it is indirectly checking whether the unique array is index of array of 0. Yes, it will try to return -1 usually, because if the element is not there, as we have discussed here, 50 is not there in array, so it will try to return -1. In the same way, unique dot index of array of 0 1, that is for Johnny, it will try to return as -1. So if it is -1, if the element is not there, if the condition is true, it should able to print, that is it should able to push into this array. So I'm trying to write push of array of I. So based upon the array index value, it will try to print. So if we can see here, it is trying to do in this way. Let me check the output now. It is undefined. Why? After trying to push all the array elements, we should also return that array. We should always return that array. So I'm trying to return unique here. So can you see Johnny, Arif, Meena, Sridhar and Vasu? So let me take one more name. The same name. For example, I'm trying to take Arif here again. If we can see here, we got the same array. For example, I'm trying to take the new array element followed by Ramu. Yes, we got this array elements. So this is how we have done with the basic using basic for loop push index of methods. We are trying to use this predefined methods and we are trying to print the distinct array elements, that is it is trying to remove those duplicate elements and it is trying to print individual elements, that is Ramu, Johnny, Arif, Meena, Sridhar and Vasu. So this is how we have done. So let us elaborate this for loop, how it works. Let us elaborate this for loop again in the presentation so that we can understand. If we can see here, we were trying to print the unique array elements. Now if we can see, first one index of, let me enclose this thing in this way so that we can write for the first one. So let me write using this same presentation what we have done here. Let me write the same thing so that we can elaborate in this. For the first iteration, instead of looking into the presentation, let us type. In the first iteration, the value will be 0. It means first it will try to calculate I equals to 0, I less than array dot length. Here array dot length is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so 8 I plus. It means array index starts from 0 to 7, it is equals to this values. So in this, first it will try to check the if condition. unique. Unique is an empty array, no? Index of array of 0. Array of 0 triple equal, that is equals to minus 1. It means indirectly it is trying to check index of, what is the first element we have here? First element we have array of 0 is Ramu equals to minus 1. Yes, because it is an empty array, it is minus 1. So it what it will try to do, it will try to push. So array, that is unique array, push. So it will try to push that element, that is Ramu here. As it is array of 0, the first element will be Ramu here. First element will be Ramu. Now in the next iteration, Johnny. So for the next iteration also, it will try to pass. Control C. For the next iteration, it will be 1. It will try to check the condition here. Now array of 1. What is array of 1 here? Johnny here. So as it is also equals to minus 1, it will try to push the array element here. So it will try to push Johnny. Next one is Arif. Next one is Meena. So it will try to iterate this loop as we are trying to increment the values from 0 to 10. So in this way, it will try to iterate the list of array elements, and at the end it will try to iterate 1, 2, 3, 4, all the array elements till 7 as the index value, the length of an array. Based upon the length of an array, it will try to perform these iterations. First iteration, and this one is second iteration. Array is equals to minus 1. Now here it will be Johnny. So it will be Johnny here. So this is how we have done with the basic example of printing the distinct array elements. Like if you have any queries, like the same example we have done in the presentation but in the different array names, so I have done the same thing there. It will try to iterate for the each and every array element. You can just pause this and you can look into this how it goes. The same what we have done in the editor, it is the same. Like if you have any queries, if you need any explanation of the programs, you can just drop us a mail or comment below this video. Thank you.